कॉफ़ी ज़रूरी है क्योंकि ये रिकॉर्डिंग रात के 1:30 बजे हो रही है। आज की वीडियो इज़ गोन बी अबाउट एक्सेसरीज। नो, इट्स नॉट गोन बी अबाउट मोटरसाइकिल एक्सेसरीज, इट्स गोइंग टू बी अबाउट हेलमेट एक्सेसरीज। स्टे ट्यून्ड। Welcome everybody, welcome back to another video, and today's video is about this bad boy. No, not this helmet in particular, but the video is about the accessories which go along with your helmet. Now, helmet is one of those things which you usually buy before you even buy your bike, or you know, before you sit on your bike for the first time, sit on your new bike for the first time. And it's severely overlooked, at least in India, the importance of helmet. I would always recommend that you buy a DOT or ECE certified, or if you can get a Snell helmet, that's gonna be great. But this video is not about helmets and why they are important. I would hope that everybody who watches this video at least knows and understands why helmets are important. So keeping that aside, what we are going to be talking about today is accessories for this helmet. So when I say this helmet, I don't mean this helmet in particular. I'm talking about any helmet in general. Let me keep this aside for a minute. So I mean, any sane person would ask me why accessories for the helmet. So these accessories are not for your daily commuter. These accessories are specifically targeted towards people who do touring, who use this helmet for extended periods of times, anywhere above 5 hours, 10 hours on the road. When you drive for that long amount of time, there are small annoyances which you'd not necessarily feel in a short commute, but when you keep experiencing those on a longer run, it sort of becomes a nuisance. So keeping that in mind, let's talk about our first accessory, which is right here. It's the visor. Let me pull another one. Usually your helmets come with one visor, which is the clear visor. I have went ahead and purchased another visor. I'm using an empty Magello helmet. This visor cost me around $1,000, I think. And I'll tell you why this is important. When you're riding in a very sunny day, the sun that hits your eyes directly can fatigue you. Now, my solution, because in my initial ride I did not have this visor, and my solution was using sunglasses. So first of all, my problem is I already have glasses, so I had to wear lenses and then sunglasses. But again, I like wearing lenses when I ride, so that part was easy for me. But what happened was, whenever for a quick stop I need to pull out my helmet, many times I ended up pulling it out with the glasses, and I end up hurting myself. But I'm sure you guys are not as stupid as I am, but again, this helps a lot with that particular problem, because you then do not have to go ahead and wear lenses if you don't like wearing lenses on rides, and then you don't have to go ahead and use those sunglasses, because sometimes they are very tight on the temple and it can cause headaches and so on and so forth. So it's always a good idea to have like a dark visor with you for those sunny days. Now the problem with this particular model of the helmet is removing and reattaching the visor is a chore. So what I usually do is, I just, when I know my majority of my ride is going to be a day ride, so I go ahead and use the dark visor, and on the initial few hours of the ride, when it's dark outside, I just pull up the visor and go willy-nilly. So that's a sacrifice I have to make, and that is why, from my experience, I'm gonna tell you, because this is something I did not really realize when I first bought my helmet. So for any one of you who's buying the helmet for the first time, fit and everything else is very important, but there's one more thing which is important, is how the ease of removing and replacing the visors. Because if it is not easy to remove and replace, you're gonna be most likely stuck with one visor, and during rides it's just too tedious to go ahead and change it sometimes. Okay, so that is our first accessory. Moving on to the second one. Now the second accessory also has to do with the visor, and this is called the pin lock insert. And why this is necessary is, if you see this visor right here, fortunately with M-Team Magello helmets there is like slots to insert your pin lock insert. So what happens is, when you're riding in a cold day and your body is too warm, when you breathe, you see it's gonna all fog up, and that is going to be a huge problem. So in the cold outside, you either have to pull up your visor and, you know, get all frozen, get uncomfortable, or you keep it down and affect your visibility, which is a strict no-no. And so what do? In this case, you use this kind of solution, which is a pin lock insert. Now if your visor does not have those knobs for getting the pin lock insert attached, you might have to purchase a different visor. Empty helmets come with these by default. So essentially you just hook this up and you put it right here. What this does is, it creates a small pocket of air between your visor and your face, so when you breathe, nothing happens. And I'm going to put you show a picture of a really cold day right here, where you can see it actually working, where everything else is fogged up and this pin lock insert is working really fine. And now this pin lock insert is usually very costly. This one costed me around $1,700. You don't have to invest that kind of money. There is a film which gets attached like a screen protector on your visor, and it costs like $400-$500. I've used it. I've talked about it in one of my older videos. I'll link it right here so you can watch it. So that also works really well. But the advantage with this is, you can remove it and clean it and then use it again. With that, you cannot really remove it. Once attached, it'll work for as long as it can, and once it has scratches and you can't see, you have to remove it and buy a new one. So yeah, another accessory, really important, really helps a lot with long rides. Now the third accessory is something to do with the weather right now, or the weather as it was a month or so back. As you know, it was heavily raining, and what this particular thing does is, this, look at this packet, and the name of the product is raincoat. I don't know if it's just me, I find that funny. So what this does is, it provides a hydrophobic coating for the plastics, for any kind of plastic. So I'm gonna use it on my visor. I actually already have it applied, and I'm gonna apply it on a small area and like show you how to apply this. So you just tear it off, and there's this white paste like material. It's like Colgate. I think kuch log desi juad mein Colgate laga ke bhi, they achieve the same thing, but this lasts longer. And you just go ahead and evenly spread it, so it looks something like this. You do it on the entire visor, not just this one point. I've already done it, so I'm showing you on this one point. So you leave it aside for 2 to 5 minutes, and after 2 to 5 minutes, you go ahead and buff it. So we're gonna quickly speed up 2 to 5 minutes. All right, now it has dried up. So what you see right here is, it no longer is, you know, liquidy to the touch. It's like a paste coating. And now what you do is you use a soft microfiber cloth. Very important, do not use your tissue papers or your kitchen towels or whatnot, because the thing is, if you use some material which is not a soft microfiber, you'll end up scratching the visor, and which is it's gonna defeat the entire purpose of us going ahead and doing all of this to enhance our vision. So you go ahead and just buff it out, just with a light hand buff it out, and eventually once it's buffed out, you'll see that the powder completely disappears. Now quickly, here I have a bottle of X sanitizer, now just water, right here, and I'm gonna go ahead and, okay, so if you can see, the water is just dripping away from the glass. Now this is a mist when it's raining, it's not gonna be misty. So when there is heavy water, you're gonna see water droplets fall rapidly. But for the sake of not spoiling my table, I'm not pouring that kind of water. But yeah, you can see how effectively this works, and I'll show you one more thing. Okay, so with good quality riding gloves, you usually see this kind of rubber wiper sort of a thing. What it's used for is just wiping away water. So let me just show you how easily it gets wiped away. So I'm doing this. So if you see, this is absolutely clear. With constant rain, it's gonna be much easier to clear the water from your visor, and hence this is a very important product. And if you can see this water droplets right here, it just fell off. This particular product is available from Moto Asher. I'm gonna go ahead and put in links of all of these items that I discussed down below, with an exception of visor and the pin lock insert. That's gonna be specific to MT Mugello helmet series. You have to go ahead and basically check it per your helmet, but other than that, other items are very generic. So the fourth and final item is something which is, I think, manufactured by just one manufacturer in India. It's Wyatt-Era Gear, and it's almost always out of stock. I put an email notification, and a couple of months later I actually found this product and I immediately bought it. It's not very costly, it's just $500, $499 to be exact, but it's very important. If I had this product earlier, I would have saved myself all of these scratches. I don't know if you can see it on the camera, but there are a ton of scratches. And the reason for these scratches, I did not have a proper place to store this particular visor. Now, if you didn't understand it till now, what this is a visor cover. It's waterproof, of course, and inside there is a soft microfiber cloth to ensure that there are no scratches. And your visor just simply goes in like this. Okay, once your visor is inside, you can just tie this up and you can keep it in your bag. Again, this is just gonna save it from scratches and provide a safe place to store your visor. It's not something where you can just, you know, pack it inside and throw it wherever you want. It's still fragile, it's just cloth. If you put too much weight on it, your visor is gonna break, so be very careful with it. Alright, so in summary, we saw four awesome accessories for our helmet, at least for me. They provide a great, great riding experience. They enhance my riding experience tremendously. And right now, if you ask me, I would not do without any one of these. So just to recap real quick, the first thing is the visor itself. You ought to have different kind of visors. There are 3-4 type of visors available. There is a photochromatic visor, which is not very common, but what it does is it turns clear in the night and it turns dark during daytime. If you can find one, I think that's going to be a very good solution. There are iridium visors which are reflective. They look really cool, a little too flashy for me. Then there are dark visors, which I just showed you on my helmet, and then there are clear visors. Always have a dark and a clear visor for those sunny days. You need those dark visors. The second thing that we talked about was the pin lock insert. Very important for those rides in this cold nights or cold mornings, to avoid fogging up and have a very good visibility. It's very important. The third item is the raincoat, the hydrophobic coating for those rainy rides, so you have again clear visibility. And the fourth and final one is the visor sleeve, again to avoid scratches. Keep your visor safe, keep your extra visor safe. Do not stuff in two visors in there, it defeats the purpose. So to keep your visor safe and again have a better visibility, enhance your ride, enhance your safety, that is what these accessories are mostly all about. Helmet is a safety gear, so these accessories are gonna enhance the safety. So I think this is it. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video, and hope you find some products that you actually wanted but didn't know what they were. If you figured out something new, please do comment down below and let me know. And I'll get to my coffee, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye, take care, ciao. So if you stuck till here, this is the third time I shot this video. I started at around 9:30, though it was the first shot. There was a huge problem with with my mic, and there was some background noise. Then I shot another one at 11. That was my best take. I was very happy. I transferred the footage, and then I figured out, well, my helmet has a speaker, and there was an audiobook running, audiobook playing on that speaker. And funnily enough, since there is so less sound here, the fan is switched off and everything, you could pick it up just a little bit in the background, so it's very annoying. And now this is the third time. I don't think this came out as good as the first two times, but I still went ahead and did it the third time. That's the fun. Just a bit of BTS behind the scenes, what happened kind of a situation that I wanted to share. I am wasting too much time on this. Alright, bye.